course, as I said, Israel began to confiscate the land of the Palestinians immediately after the first day of the independence of it, in May 48. And in the beginning, they confiscate a lot of land until the people, they have very few rest. It's only the really very necessary. And it was in 76, they decided to confiscate a piece of land in the other side of Sakhalin. From here, we cannot see it, which actually in the middle, among three Arab villages, Sakhalin, and that one is called Arabi, and another one called Sakhalin, Deir Hanna. So, and it was very big, the last agricultural piece of land for these three villages. And it was too much for the people here. Then they decided to make a peaceful strike and demonstrations. It was in 30 March 76. But in the government in that time was Peres. And you know Peres, who is now is the president of Israel. And Rabin, who was assassinated about 10 years ago, they were in the government. And they decided to break this strike by force. And then they sent the army with the tanks. And it was look for the people like another occupation like what happened in 48. So actually Sakhalin occupied two times, one in 48 and the second time again in 76, in this day. And in that time it was only just a strike, we didn't call it land day. But after this day when the police and the army came inside, they killed six people, three of them from Sakhalin, one of them from Arabi, and another two from another village. Yeah. And many people were injured and were arrested and something like that. But Israel has later to stop the confiscation because of this uprising. And now people from Sakhalin and Arabi still have some land. Maybe 10% of what had before, but at least something. So, two artists, one Palestinian, it's called Abid Abidi, who live in Haifa, and one Jewish, democratic Jewish artist, it's called Kinspel Gershon, they built this monument to remember what happened in 76. And now, every year in 30 March, it's become kind of national day for the whole Palestinian who live here, but also the Palestinian who live everywhere in the West Bank, in Gaza, in the Arab countries, everywhere. They commemorate this day as symbol of defending the land of the Palestinian here. So this is the story of the monument.